Good morning everyone. So we have completed our chapter number 5, that is multiplication, and today we will start chapter number 6, that is division. But before starting division, let's recall chapter number 5, that is multiplication. So if we have to multiply 184 with 26, now what is 184 called? Here 184 is called multiplicand. Multiplicand. And here 26 is called multiplier. Let's start multiplication. Whenever we have to multiply, we'll start from the right hand side of the multiplier. And now I'll multiply 6 with all the digits of multiplicand, starting from the right hand side. So first I'll multiply 6 with 4. So 6 fours are 24. So 4 here and 2 carry. The number you are carrying, put them in the circle. Now you will multiply 6 with 8. 6 8s are 48 and 2 will be 50. So 0 carry 5. Now you will multiply 6 with 1. 6 1 is 6 plus 5 will be 11. Now before multiplying the second digit of the multiplier with the multiplicand, here you will put a cross. Now let's multiply 2 with 4. 2 4s are 8. 2 8s are 16. So 6 carry 1. Now 2 1 is 2 and 1 we have in carry. So it will be 3. Now after this, add all this. So here it will be 4. 8 7 4. This is your answer. So this is how you will multiply. One more thing. You will call it product. What is this? Product. So what is product? Product is the answer of multiplication. What is product? Answer of multiplication. So this is how you will multiply. One more example I am giving you of multiplication, in which we will be having three digits in the multiplier. So the number is 3, 4, 8, 2, and you have to multiply it with 1, 6, 3. I am not writing here, but what is this? This is multiplicand, this is multiplier. If you have to start multiplication, from where you will start? You will start from the right hand side of the multiplier. You will pick the first digit of the multiplier from the right hand side. And you will start the multiplication from the right hand side of multiplicand. Here 3 2s are 6. 3 8s are 24. So 4 carry 2. Now 3 4s are 12. And 2 will be 14. So 4 carry 1. 3 3s are 9. And 1 will be 10. Now you will put a cross here. Now you multiply 6 with 2. 6 2s are 12. So 2 carry 1. Now 6 8s are 48 and 1 will be 49. Now 6 4s are 24 and 4 will be 28. 6 3s are 18 and 2 will be 20. Now in the third, before multiplying with the third digit, you will put 2 times cross here. And now let's multiply 1 with 2, that is 2. 1 with 8, 8. 1 with 4 is 4. 1 with 3 is 3. Put a line and add all this. So 6, 6, 5 carry 1, 7 carry 1, 6 and 5. And this is your answer, means this is your product. But don't leave till here, put commas. Leaving three digits from the right hand side, put a comma, then two digits like this. This is according to Indian system of numeration. Clear everyone? So now let's start our chapter number 6, that is division. First of all, tell me what is division? What is division? Can anybody tell me what is division? Okay, I am telling you what do you mean by division. Division is splitting into equal parts or group. Division is splitting into equal parts or a group. For example, there are 12 chocolates. How many chocolates? 12. Why I always give you examples of chocolates or pen? Because I know you all love chocolate, right? Okay, so there are 12 chocolates and 3 friends want to share them. So there are 12 chocolates and 3 friends wants to share them. How do they share that? So solution is, how many chocolates they have? 12. And how many friends? 3. So we have 3 friends and 12 chocolates and we have to share equally. So we know the table of 3. You can write here 3 1 is 3, 3 2s are 6, 3 3s are 9, 3 4s are 12, 3 5s are 15 and so on. And we know 3 4s are 12. Done? Now this means each one of them, each friend will get 4 chocolates. Clear? Next is, we have 4 important terms in division. We have 4 important terms in division, that is dividend. First one is dividend. Next is divisor. Next is quotient. And the last one is remainder. So we have 4 important terms in division. First is dividend. What is dividend? The number to be divided is called dividend. The number to be divided. So I am writing in short, number to be divided. The number to be divided is called dividend. Now what is divisor? The number which divides. The number which divides the other number is called divisor. And what is quotient? Answer of division. What is quotient? Answer of division is known as quotient. And what is remainder? Number we are left with at the end. The number we are left with at the end is called remainder. I am giving you one example now. For example, you are dividing 244 with 3. So whenever you are dividing any, write the table of the divisor. So first of all, you have to write the table of 3. So 3 1 is 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18, 21, 24, 27 and 30. Now you have to check the first digit of the dividend. Before telling all this, let me tell you what is dividend and divisor. The number, this number, from which you are dividing is called divisor. And the number which you are dividing is called dividend. So this is called dividend. The number which you are dividing is called dividend. Again, the number which you are dividing is called dividend. And the number from which you are dividing is called divisor. Now, of divisor, you have to write table Here I have written table of divisor. Now check the first digit of dividend, whether it is divisible by divisor or not. No. If you will take only 2, you can't divide it with the 3 because 2 is smaller than 3. So whenever this is smaller, means first digit is smaller than the divisor, take 2 digits of the dividend. So I am taking 2 digits of the dividend. Now check, is 24 is divisible by 3? Yes, 24 is divisible by 3. It will go on 8. So 8 and 24. Done. Now carry 4. Now check, is 4 is divisible by 3? No, 4 is not divisible by 3. So which number you will take? Now you have to take number less than 4 but closest to 4, which is divisible by 3. So here I'll write 3 only, because 4 is not divisible by 3 but 3 is divisible by 3 and it is closest to 4, and it will go on 1. 3 1 is 3, and now this is 1. Now this is called remainder. What is this? Remainder. The number which is left over at the end is called remainder, and this is called quotient. Quotient means answer of division. So this is quotient, this is remainder, this is divisor, and this is dividend. Dividend, the number which you are dividing. Divisor, the number from which you are dividing. Quotient, answer of division. And remainder is the number which is left over at the end. Clear everyone? Now, last thing. You know, we have just completed chapter multiplication. So now I am telling you the relationship between multiplication and division. Now, what is the relationship between multiplication and relation between multiplication and division? You know, there is one very interesting fact about multiplication and division. Multiplication is inverse of division. Inverse means opposite. So multiplication is opposite of division, and vice versa means division is also opposite of multiplication. Now how? Let me tell you this. See, whenever you have done multiplication and you have to check your answer, whether your answer is correct or not, divide them. And if you have to check whether your answer is correct of division or not, you will multiply. And what is the formula to check? To check whether your answer is correct or division or not, the formula is dividend is equal to quotient multiply divisor. What is the formula? Dividend is equal to quotient plus, sorry, multiply divisor. For example, here if you want to divide 12 with 3, so let's divide them. 3, 12. It will directly go on 4. So here 3 is divisor, 12 is dividend, 4 is quotient. Means your answer is 4, that is quotient. So this is, you have done division, and if you want to check whether your answer is correct or not, you will apply this formula. What is dividend here? 12. Dividend must be equal to quotient multiply divisor. Multiply these two. 12 is equal to 12. That means your answer is absolutely correct. So whenever you have to check answer of division, you will apply this formula. But we have one more case. Now what is that? If remainder is there, then what you will do? Then there is a slight change in the formula. That is, in case of remainder, in case of remainder, the formula is dividend is equal to divisor multiply quotient plus remainder. In case of remainder, the formula is dividend is equal to divisor multiply quotient plus remainder. For example, 313, it will go on 4. So here 1 is remainder, 4 is quotient, this is divisor and 13 is dividend. So to check this, let's apply the formula. Dividend is 13. It must be equal to divisor, that is 3 multiply 4 plus 1. So 12 plus 1 is 13. So both are same. That means your answer is correct. Now your homework is to do practice of division sums. Thank you.